medical pharmaceutical market is a little bit different from others, a lot different from the others that we generally deal with as government entities because of the complexity of the market and the number of products and services that we need to obtain to run our operations. The market is extremely complex. Different classes of trade, so different types of organizations receive different pricing. Our nursing home receives different pricing than our medical examiner's office, for example, on certain items. And there are different tier levels based on the amount of commitment that we put into buying from one particular distributor or manufacturer around a class of goods and around the amount of spend that we have. So this industry, we're accustomed in government agencies to getting a price list from for one of these competitively bid contracts. And we're accustomed to being able to use that price list and apply that price list to any entity, any one of our departments that we might use. This complexity of the healthcare market does not allow for a single price list. There are hundreds of thousands of items that are available to public agencies via this U.S. Communities contract based on the contracts that Premier provides us access to. It's necessary for us as public agencies to declare a preference with Premier as our preferred GPO because in the healthcare industry, it's common for organizations to participate in more than one GPO. And it's necessary for the manufacturers to know which GPO is designated as primary. Because we are using the Premier contract under U.S. Communities, and that's our competitively bid option via Dane County's contract, it may seem a little bit unusual for us to do that, but it's really a part of the industry and the way that it works, so the manufacturers understand where we're coming from and can provide us with the correct pricing. The reason for that is that the manufacturers are providing us additional discounts via our distributors, excellent discounts that we can take advantage of to leverage more funding for us to do other things within our nursing home and our medical examiner's office. But we needed to make that commitment and that declaration to the manufacturer in order to be able to do that. And the forms that Premier provides are the mechanism by which they do that. It really threw us for a loop at Dane County that our medical examiner's office and our nursing home would receive different pricing based on the fact that they were different types of organizations in the healthcare universe. It's not something that we're accustomed to dealing with, but that is the nature of the medical product, Med-Surg product market. So it's not something that we have control over. It's not something that U.S. Communities has control over or even Premier has control over. It's the nature of the market. But we found that working within those constraints of the market, working within those differences of the market, that we've been able to achieve some real significant savings for Dane County. And so taking a little time to understand that and to become comfortable with that really has been in the best interest of the county.